I am like so excited to do this.
Enjoy it, have fun, don't care what other people say.
So, are you ready for this? Number. Okay, so I am so excited to do this video. I've been waiting for so long. And first off, this is my go-to church outfit and also my Bitmoji dress that I wear with a little hat. So, I am gonna give you my personal list of the 10 must-haves for... So, several months before I try to conceive, I like to prepare myself mentally, but I also like to distract myself and collect a few things to in anticipation. And that's a fun part of, you know, the whole trying to conceive. So this is my personal top 10 things I like to treat myself and collect. This is what I personally do in the months prior to trying to conceive. Now let me be clear, I do this within like 6 months before we intentionally start trying. So the number one thing is I start tracking my period on the Ovio app or the pregnancy tracker. I personally love and prefer to use the Ovia app right now because I am trying to conceive and that's what it is directed and focused on. But the period tracker is a wonderful tool too. But the reason I also like the Ovia app is because it helps me predict my ovulation period. So number one, I download those apps onto my phone and I try to keep 12 to 6 months beforehand journal on my app. Number two, the prenatals. I start taking these 3 months before I try to conceive, so that way my body is fortified and prepared for this baby. This is my favorite, is the, okay, so I'm gonna look down to my notes, okay? I'm so nervous, I'm so excited about this video. So this is my Rainbow Light Duo. It's $30. And it's plant-based, nutrient from food. It has omega-3, it has fish oil with DHA nutrients. And I'm also taking, here we go, folate. I know these contain folic acid, but folate is the natural form. It's not artificial like folic acid. So I can't stress how important it is for you to take either folic acid or hopefully folate. Do your research, but I believe, and so has the research backed it up, is by the time you find out you're pregnant, a lot of the nervous system is already formed in the baby. And this is so important to prevent diseases. Anyways, number three is a trusty journal to write down all your research, all your information. I love keeping a journal before as I try to conceive. And I found this adorable journal. Like, how cute is this avocado journal? And, you know, avocado, they kind of remind me of pregnant women. And it has a little zip place here to put in all of my trusty favorite pens. Number four, being physically active is such an important part of trying to conceive and actually being pregnant. It's even gonna help you recover from pregnancy. Another way to keep me motivated to work out 3 to 4 times a week is buying new workout clothes. Now, yes, I might get pregnant in the next few months, but that's why I go to Walmart and Marshalls and TJ Maxx, and you'll be surprised how great prices you find for the cutest little workout outfits. I like to put on these little outfits early in the morning, and that way by the time the afternoon comes and my husband comes home from work, I'm already dressed. So that's one less excuse for why I can't work out. Like, for me, that's half the battle. Number five. I know a lot of people struggle with this, but keeping hydrated. So in order to make sure that I do keep hydrated and in order for me not to have an excuse why not to, I have, this is my jumbo 24/7 water bottle. This one where I connect my key with a hook. Where's the hook at? This is my workout bottle that fits perfectly into my car or into the workout machines. And this is my nighttime, so adorable Christmas Santa Claus riding a unicorn. My husband did not understand why I needed to spend $5 on this, but I have no excuse. I have a water bottle next to my bed. I have a water bottle all over the house, and I have a water bottle to go work out with. It keeps my kids hydrated. Side note, if you don't have little ones around, I would use the glass bottles, but it's too big of a risk for me. My kids break everything. So important to make sure that all of these water bottles are BPA free. Okay, so I'm gonna read this because I'm a mess. BPA is bisphenol A, an organic synthetic compound that binds to estrogen receptors that influence growth, cell repair, fetal development, energy levels, and reproduction, along with a whole bunch of things. Personally, in my home, we switch to glass containers. I do use those. We filter our own water, and I just make sure every piece of plastic that comes into my house is BPA free because of that. Number six is treating the largest organ in your body. I finally went ahead and I got the complete stretch mark care kit. My first pregnancy, I used these guys like crazy. With my second, I kind of slipped up a little bit and I wasn't that consistent. So with this pregnancy, I'm gonna try to be more careful and take care of my body and my growing bump.
Number 7.
Like I said before, we filter our own water. We try to avoid anything that's plastic or has BPA in our home. And we try to eat clean and healthy. That's another point, but that's for later, another video. But it is so important for you to de-stress and detox your body in the months leading to try to conceive. It takes 100 days to form an egg, and it takes 75 days to It takes 72 hours to form sperm. So we're trying to cleanse our bodies, and some of the things that we do is Epsom salt baths. I love Epsom salt. My husband and I try to do these twice a week. Sometimes it's once, sometimes it's three times a week. It's so relaxing, and it's great bonding time too. And hello, you're detoxifying. Another way that I try to detoxify my body in preparation for pregnancy is I avoid tampons. Tampons have a whole bunch of chemicals in you, and it's inside of you for so many hours, and you can get toxified from it, and you can actually die if you leave a tampon in you for an X amount of period. So I use the cup. Yeah. Still haven't found a good cup that doesn't make me feel uncomfortable. So I tried these cotton tampons. That wasn't good either. So I stick to the cup and I bear it out for the last few months. But the cup is great. It's just not that practical and not that convenient. At least I'm not putting those chemicals into my body, and I'm not worried or anxious that my tampon has been in there for too long. I'm sorry, TMI. This video is gonna be full of TMI. It's a pregnancy preparation video. Another way that I like to take care of myself is to do all the things that I won't be able to do once I'm pregnant. Like get my roots all filled in, certain facials or peelings that I know might be toxic. Right now I am using Visibly Even. I still have a ton of dark spots from my last two pregnancies, so this is wonderful for that. I sleep with sleeping caps. My husband actually doesn't mind. He's a picky man, but he doesn't really mind the sleeping caps. And I have satin here. This is satin. And this is silk. Same amount of money. The silk is so much better. I hate these satins. I barely use them. I use them for emergency. Do is I roll up my hair into this cap. There you go. There you go. And when I'm sleeping, or when one of the kids wake me up, even, oh, this is wonderful for when you're nursing, because you can just pull it over your eyes. Voila, no hair, nothing, no knots in the back when you're tossing and turning. This is wonderful for after you have a baby too. I protect my hair, especially since I dye it. I need to go the extra mile to make sure that my pillows and my sheets don't tear it up when I'm sleeping. Another thing that helps me de-stress, there's my coffee. Okay, I still drink coffee. I know I should cut down my coffee, but it's just something I need. I'm a mom of two boys. I've got a 3-year-old and a 1.5-year-old. I need coffee. But my diffuser is on 24/7 and I use essential oils. It helps me de-stress. And right now, since we're getting close to Christmas, honestly, I do it all the time. I need that little pick-me-up. I am loving the combination of pine, clove, and peppermint. It smells like Christmas all the time. I love to fall asleep with that. And that is just another way that helps me de-stress and prepare me for bed. And especially when my kids wake up in the middle of the night, I just pop that thing back on and breathe it in and let it wash away the stress. I did laser removal. And as you know, it's not permanent. It is pretty permanent. Like I haven't retouched my legs in about 2 years, and I don't really need to. But for the bikini area, for the underarm area, I like to get them retouched. But once I'm pregnant or once I'm trying to conceive, they recommend that you not do so. And all those hormone changes will cause the growth to come back even stronger. So I will need some retouches after post-pregnancy. So what I do while I'm pregnant is these NADS Bikini Underarm Wax Strips. These are awesome. I've used so many different wax strips and I regret buying another brand every time. These, they don't have a strong odor. These don't leave much residue on my body, and they actually work. I told my kid, don't come in here unless the house is on fire or you're bleeding. He came in bleeding. Boys, he literally came in bleeding. This is another tip. If your kid is bleeding, do not freak out. Tell them, oh, that's okay, we'll fix it. Do you want a Band-Aid? Do you want something? Totally changes the climate. Anyways, let's move on. Now for number 9. Now this is my favorite part. Number 9. Okay, I know a ton of people are gonna comment on number 9 and number 10. I'm gonna hear it, whatever. But this is, hey, this is supposed to be fun. You're supposed to enjoy this. You're supposed to prepare yourself mentally, emotionally, in every way possible for this baby. Enjoy it, have fun. Don't care what other people say. So, are you ready for this? 9. Whenever I go to the dollar store, I like to pick up 1 or 2 pregnancy and ovulation tests. These are just some of my collection. I actually have more than these. I love these cheap dollar store pregnancy and ovulation tests. Even though I know when I'm ovulating, I kind of like to know more or less, you know, how soon and how close I am, especially if you are trying for that boy. So you should do the deed when you are ovulating. Or if you're trying for a girl, you should do it several days before you ovulate. So this is gonna be interesting. I've never done ovulation tests before. You learn something new every day. This is gonna be my 3rd attempt to try it for a baby, so. And I'm still learning. The reason why I love these dollar store pregnancy tests, because even though they're not as sensitive as the other brand name ones, it's even better because if you do get a positive on these tests, it's almost impossible for you to get a positive and actually be a negative, because these are not as sensitive. So if you get a positive, that means you really are pregnant. And it's also good to have these handy just in case a little accident happened and you're not, I don't know, you know, instead of having to send your husband or running over to the pharmacy, hey, I have a drawer full of them. Another thing I love about these pregnancy tests is, since I have so many of them, I like to start testing early. If I do get a positive, I'd like to keep on testing them until they get dark. It's just a little quirk. Some people do that. Hey, I know people who do that. Whatever. Okay, and number 10. This is so bad. This is something like, oh my gosh. I'm gonna admit this. Oh my gosh. The thing is, we know we want another baby. And if I do get pregnant, I might have seen something months before. And I'll be like, oh gosh, that's so cute. I wish I had purchased that. Oh, I saw that a few years ago. I wish I had, you know? Or if I see an awesome deal, I'm like, oh my goodness, how adorable, how awesome is that, you know? And regardless if it's a boy or girl, if I end up having either a boy or girl, not the same sex of the item I purchased, I can always give it to one of my sisters, one of my good friends, my pastor's wife. So let me show you what I have bought. How cute is this from TJ Maxx? Look at that cute little bow. It has a little bit of gold and shimmer. Heck, it blends right in with our room. And it has the most adorable little bonnets. How precious is this? I could not pass it up. I'm sorry, I couldn't pass it up. I've never had a girl. I don't know, it's something came over me. It's $14, but hey, it was $22 beforehand. It's light for the summerish Floridian weather. I got this in a 3 to 6 month size and I do not regret it. I love it. Mine. This get up here, you'll be like, what? Are you serious? It's actually $8. I got this for $8. It has the cute little pantyhose. It has the lace neck and bodice that goes wraps around. And it has the bonnet. Are you kidding me? And I got it for $8. Like, these are the kind of things that you just can't pass up. And if not, my sisters and my friends would thank me very much for giving them this. Look at this! Anyways, boy mom here. Another thing I couldn't pass up, look how cute is this little pajama. Oh, I just can't get enough. I got this in 6 months, 12 to 16 pounds. This I got at Babies R Us before they closed down, and I got it on sale, and it's a boy blanket. I already have a ton of boy things. I don't need to purchase any more boy things, but I couldn't pass up this blanket. Look at this, and if it's a girl, heck, it'll look super cute on the girl too. Okay, wait for a moment. Well, these were my top 10 must-have treat yourself trying to conceive what to get before you start planning your pregnancy list. These are just my personal must-haves, and this is what I would tell my sisters or my girlfriends, that, you know, hey, you should treat yourself. A few little extras that make life so much fun. These are not necessities for trying to conceive. These are just a little extra that help distract me and make the whole process so much fun and entertaining, and a way to for you to distract yourself. As a mom, we do so much. As wives, as women, we do so much. So we need to take care of ourselves, and we need to treat ourselves too. Bye-bye, thank you for watching.
Don't flush the toilet, Nico, okay? Nico? No, do not flush the toilet. Can you close the door, please? Thank you, love you.